Hi, my name is Ian Martin Allison, and I am here today with SBL talking to you about Tim Commerford. You might know him from Rage Against the Machine, from Audio Slave, Prophets of Rage. And so I am thrilled today to talk about this wonderful bass player, break down a bunch of these lines, and then I'm gonna show you how to achieve some of these sounds with a very simple pedal setup, okay? So this is the 10 greatest Rage Against the Machine bass lines by Tim Commerford. Now, before we dive in, let me just say, like, I know that people are gonna be like, how come you didn't include this tune? Include this tune. Here's the deal. I know that I'm gonna leave out a bunch of Rage stuff. I mean, even as I was making this, I was clicking on tunes going like, you've got to be kidding me. This is so good. I wanted to make 20, but listen, I have 10 compiled here. We're gonna go through chronologically. First up, self-titled 1992, Rage Against the Machine. I mean, here I come out of Mr. Anderson's history class, right? And my friend is like, dude, check this out. Puts the Sony headphones on me, and I hear this. Think of this, 1992, like hair metal is still happening. It's like right at the beginning of grunge, and this band emerges in California and is like crushing the same venues that like Rat and Winger is playing. I mean, just put that into historical perspective. It's crazy. That giant riff that they go into, I'm putting on a drive in the HX and I'm playing. We have to talk about this riff. I remember hearing that thinking like, whoa, what? How is he getting that sound? And all it is just fifths that fall. So cool. Next up, same record, 1992, Killing in the Name. I mean, this thing is iconic. All right, so I'm drop D, right? Open string, hammer on from C to D. Then I'm dropping my hand and playing a ghost note. And then when he gets to the verse, distortion comes off. And you hear that bright clang of the Stingray. Now let me just show you one thing really quick. If I turn off the amp and cab simulator, doesn't really sound much like Timmy C, does it? Turn back on that SVT Bright, that 810 cab. It also handles drive so nicely. And wah. We're gonna get to that in a minute. All right, next up, same record. Oh, there's so many good songs on this record. Take the Power Back, still 1992, self-titled, Rage Against the Machine. This is where Tim is playing some slap bass, and he doesn't do a ton of slap bass with Rage, but this is a really fun example. We're drop D. Let's hear him. Oh man, it's such a great riff. I mean, that is like all you need. Let's check it out, let's slow it down. Here's the thing about slapping. First of all, we're gonna bring our thumb down on the string and we're gonna let it land on this part of the wood of the fingerboard. Not any of this, not this business. That sounds anemic. That, oh, there's so much power in that strike. So here's what we do. We've got a couple of slaps. Hammer, chop on the F, and then we're hammering back on the D. And then we're popping the C to D hammer on. Dead note, F again. Next up, Know Your Enemy, self-titled record featuring Maynard from Tool. Here we go. And again, talk about rhythms. These are almost all on offbeats, right? If we slow it down, one and two, and and. I mean, right there, it's so cool. It's not just all on the beat, right? It's all off beats. So you really have to know. You have to be intentional about playing those rhythms. Oh, next up, off of Evil Empire, Bulls on Parade. And I've got to put this bass away and exchange it for this one. Hold on. And again, pentatonic all day long, but with these rhythms, right? It's all about the intentionality of those rhythms. Next up, off of Evil Empire, Down Rodeo. Check this out. Let's grab the chorus. Big distorted sound. And then we have this thing. And what he's doing there is playing a harmonic right behind the fourth fret. And it's getting approximately a G flat. And then the second time he plays, and that is grabbing the harmonic on the fifth fret on the G string, which is playing a high G. Incredible. Tim, you're a monster. So fun. Let's keep going. Next up is Guerrilla Radio off of the Battle of Los Angeles. Check this out. And again, monster riff, right? And then we get that great figure at the end. Takes us into the verse, clean it up. Oh, how about that tenth? Hey, come here. Let's have another little sneaky bass lesson. A tenth, if you don't know, is it's just a third that's up an octave. So in this case, we're in the key. A lot of Rage keys are this key. F sharp minor, right? And so F sharp and A, the A is the third of F sharp. If you take that third up an octave, right, it becomes a tenth. And so the top of these verses, he's playing. All this space that goes by. Guerrilla Radio. Oh, I love this era of Rage. Let's keep going. Next up, Battle of Los Angeles. Calm Like a Bomb. I'm so excited to get to this point because it's time to bust out the wah. Now look, Tim may have used the wah before this, but this was really the first time that I was like, what on earth is going on there? I'm gonna talk to you all about it, but first, let's check it out. I mean, really, the The sound is what's making it here, right? So here's the deal. I have a wah, it's the Dunlop 105Q sandwiched in between a couple of drives. Now check this out, if I turn off the drives, you hear it. That's just then the wah with the dirt from the Ampeg amp model. But now let's put a drive before the wah. Better. Here's the thing that I discovered just sort of by accident. If you put then a drive, this is the Tima model in the HX. Now, if you put that on after, you just have all this range, right? So then it becomes about the expression of your foot. Okay, next up, off of the Battle of Los Angeles, mic check. Now, if you know this song, you might be like, Ian, it's just two notes. What have I been telling you this whole time? It's not about the notes, right? It's about the rhythms. It's about the space. It's about the sounds. Check this thing out. Again, I've got this wah happening, sandwiched between two drives, then running into an SVT model, and you just get this, all this expression. And so then the whole game becomes how you're using your foot to express the notes. Maybe. Two notes. Who knew? Who knew the two notes could be so much fun? The last song, thank you for sticking with me. You shall be rewarded for your patience and your persistence. Because this song, all the effects are gonna come on. In 2000, Rage puts out this record, Renegades. It's mostly covers. Here's a song called I'm Housing. I love the way this record was mixed. I think this is Brendan O'Brien that mixed it, but it just sounds like your speakers are like on fire. And part of that is Tim playing these big drive sounds and then adding an octave pedal. So really what I'm doing for this is I have the three-leaf octave pedal. I have a drive in the HX and I also have the Doom 2 going too. So there's two drives and an octave pedal. There's just the SVT sound. Now, if I add the octave, and I'm playing this really light, Tim plays this hard. The drive, the fuzz. Hey, and I also told you that near the end of the video, your patience would be rewarded with all the effects pedals on, right? Last chorus of this tune, let's fire up the wah with the octave, with the overdrive, with the fuzz from the Doom 2, and let's get crazy. Check it out. I have been Ian Martin Allison, and I am thrilled to be a part of this SBL community. Here's the deal. You don't want to miss out on anything, right? You want to maybe go click that subscribe button. You maybe want to leave a comment. What did I not cover? I mean, so many things. Please, in the comments below, tell me what you want to see. Do I need to do a Rage Timmy C Volume 2? Do I need to do Audio Slave? Are there other bass players that you want to see me kind of dig into? You know, we go through and we read these comments. Do you guys know that? And so if you give me feedback in the comments, it's going to help curate the channel and make it even better, make it even more valuable for you. Because what do you need in your life, right? More bass, yes, indeed. So once again, thank you so much for watching. I have been Ian Martin Allison for SBL, and I'm gonna say it again. I'll see you in the shed.